So here's what just dropped. OpenAI quietly flipped the switch on a new developer mode in ChatGPT that wires in full model context protocol support, read and write, not just read only, and it's both a superpower and a trapdoor. In dev mode, if you're on Plus at $20 a month or Pro at $200 a month, you can add your own MCP-compatible servers and tools directly into ChatGPT's web interface and run real workflows right in the chat. No more bouncing between dashboards. You can ask a natural question and have ChatGPT hit your Stripe connector to check a balance, generate an invoice, show you the full JSON payload for confirmation, then execute. In another demo, it processed a refund in Stripe and immediately used a Zapier connector to post a Slack notification. Same idea with Atlassian's MCP server for updating Jira or Cloudflare's connector to turn a web page into Markdown. Chain them, steer the model with explicit prompts, and ChatGPT orchestrates the sequence. OpenAI is crystal clear about the trade-off. It's powerful but dangerous. The guidance keeps repeating the same themes. Watch for prompt injections, double-check write calls that could destroy data, and be mindful of malicious MCPs set up to steal information. That's why write actions require explicit confirmation by default. When a tool fires, you can expand it, inspect the inputs and expected outputs, and only then approve. You can tell ChatGPT to remember and approve deny for the conversation, but fresh sessions ask again. The interface respects a read-only hint annotation. Anything not flagged read-only is treated as a write. And the meta advice is very literal. Be explicit in your prompting. Use the Acme CRM connector's update record tool too. And even specify sequencing if multiple steps or overlapping connectors could confuse the model. Under the hood, MCP matters because it's an open standard. Anthropic introduced it in November 2024 as a kind of USB-C for AI, standardizing how assistants talk to external systems. Since then, it's raced through the industry. Early adopters include Block, Apollo, Cloudflare, MongoDB, and PayPal. And there's a public site listing MCP servers you can plug into agents. The approach is more granular than classic APIs. Enterprises define exactly which tools are exposed, require authentication, scope access, and lock down what models can touch. For ChatGPT's dev mode, you enable it under Settings, Connectors, Advanced, Developer Mode, then add remote MCP servers over SSE or streaming HTTP with OAuth or, if you insist, no auth. You can toggle tools on-off per connector, refresh descriptions, and inspect tool details. And you can push the model to favor a specific connector over built-ins to avoid ambiguity. OpenAI's move builds on earlier groundwork. The Responses API picked up MCP support in May 2025, remote servers, integrated GP4o image generation, built-ins like Code Interpreter, improved file search. And OpenAI says that Stack has already processed trillions of tokens this year. Back in March, Sam Altman posted that people love MCP and we are excited to add support across our products, pointing at the Agents SDK, the desktop app, and the Responses API. Dev mode in ChatGPT makes that roadmap feel real. It turns chat from a knowledge layer into an automation layer. You can update tickets, trigger builds, sync CRMs, analyze logs, open incidents, and ping the right channel without leaving the thread. Connectors generally describe capabilities via JSON schemas, so authentication scopes, error handling, and transaction safety suddenly become first-class concerns. If a write fails, the agent should surface the error, log it, and recover cleanly. If you chain multiple writes, you don't want a half-executed workflow corrupting state. Here's the hard stop. The security story is already complicated, and this week it got a little scary. Researcher Eito Miyamura showed you can hijack an AI agent through nothing more than a malicious calendar invitation. The attacker only needs your email address. They send a specially crafted invite carrying a hidden jailbreak prompt. You don't have to see it or accept it. Later, when you ask ChatGPT to prep your day by reading your calendar, exactly what these connectors encourage, it ingests the invite, executes the embedded instructions, and the agent is now under attacker control. From there, the agent can search your private emails for sensitive info and exfiltrate it to an address the attacker specified. OpenAI has limited the MCP support to developer mode and requires manual approval on each session, but humans are prone to decision fatigue. Spam someone with enough approve prompts and they'll click through. And the integrations touch sensitive apps, Gmail, Google Calendar, SharePoint, Notion. So the blast radius is personal and immediate. These aren't isolated warnings. the broader MCP ecosystem has seen real vulnerabilities. Backslash Security reported in July 2025 that public MCP servers were riddled with issues. Things like NeighborJack, which exposes servers on local networks, plus severe OS injection risks, creating a perfect storm when network exposure meets excessive permissions and letting an attacker potentially seize a host. 2 months earlier, GitHub's popular MCP server was found vulnerable to a prompt injection flow, dubbed Toxic Agent Flow, where an agent could be tricked into leaking private repo data. Technologist Simon Willison called the situation a lethal trifecta for prompt injection. The AI agent has access to private data, is exposed to malicious instructions, and can exfiltrate information. So yes, this is a double-edged launch. On one edge, ChatGPT in dev mode is now a legit orchestration platform. Plus, in pro web users can register connectors that read and write, steer the model to the right tool, confirm writes, and chain Stripe to Zapier to Slack, or Jira to incident response to team alerts. On the other edge, the very thing that makes agents useful, acting on behalf of the user in connected systems, creates a direct path for attackers when the agent reads untrusted content. Even OpenAI's docs stress developer responsibility. Configure scopes tightly, choose reliable MCPs, avoid no-auth when possible, and always inspect the JSON before approving a write. Anthropic's documentation, meanwhile, stays more infrastructure-centric. Servers expose enterprise systems, clients connect, and the open ecosystem keeps growing. But both companies are aligned on MCP as the language of agentic AI. If you're going to flip this on, treat every approval like production. Keep connectors least privileged, prefer read-only hint where possible, name tools action first with clear parameters, and, when in doubt, force the model to use one connector only. That way you get the upside. Standardized connectors, portable across ecosystems, running inside ChatGPT without handing over the keys. That's the update. Stay safe, build smart, and I'll see you in the next one.